I played Rogue Squadron and I got to enter it. And all I could think of was, didn't Dak die in that speeder?
Didn't Dak do nothing and die?
And then get fucking crushed by an AT-AT? Yes.
That we're live now.
Oh. Hi!
Well, let's all have a moment of silence for Dak. Okay, that's enough.
He was a true hero.
Who? Hey, he did more than Captain Phasma.
Wow, he did. Well, actually,
Captain Phasma dropped the shields.
At least
he
with
did Dak, more for his side than Captain.
Yeah,
Phasma.
At least with Dak, we have closure. We know he's dead.
Yeah. Instead, she's going to get shoehorned in the next one.
You know what would be great is if they just completely forgot that they even had her. That's in the next movie.
I want that more now than anything else.
Like, they never confirm if she died or if she lived. They just never reference her ever again.
That way people can write books about her. I bet
that at the end of 7, she had somehow, like, taken control of the Starkiller base or whatever.
Like fucking IG-88.
Like IG-88.
Oh my god.
Anyway, this is session 41. You all just finished killing a bunch of stone giants who were just sitting around enjoying a dinner and whatnot.
Because we're racists.
Yeah, why did we do that?
Because
you're watching Saturday Night Live with Andy Samberg! Sandy Amberg!
Sandy Amberg.
If you're wanting to go out club hunting, the first place to go to is Yank! It's run by an old guy at the door, and the password is diabetes. Anyway, something I should mention, after you all finish killing them, especially the one who was killed slowly by being constricted and burned and pecked to death all at the same time.
Mm-hmm. What are you drawing? A whale?
A whale tail.
So you're drawing a dick?
I don't know what that part is.
That's the very tip.
That's all fucked up.
Yeah.
Get it seen if that's what yours looks like.
I don't like that.
My map's been completely taken over
by mutant dicks.
Oh, yes. My connection died. That's why it's not showing up. Wrestling.
Oh,
wrestling.
I thought you were doing something completely different.
Look at this.
Oh.
Yeah.
You notice that on their back, they each have a 7-pointed star carved into their stone flesh.
Well, son of a bitch!
So that means that the glowy chrome trail is pointing us in the right direction.
Past guidance. We've actually probably killed more things with this on them than not.
Yeah.
That means we're doing good.
Yeah, it means that we're not just killing, like, reformed hill giants.
As much as I hate to say it, maybe we should stop trying to kill things.
Eh.
But the plot won't allow it. How are we supposed to know if we're going in the right direction if we're not constantly killing things?
Alright, who wants to talk to the hill giants next time?
I suppose I'll do that.
Theodore.
I already tried!
Theodore can at least fly away.
You can only communicate with them if you have an end of one.
Well, from up here, you hear a voice call out to you in giant speak, and I think Mendez, you're the only one who knows giant speak.
Yeah.
Why do you know giant speak?
Permanent comprehend languages.
Very nice.
He knows every speak.
Everyone.
How did you get that permanent?
He's fluent in over 6 million forms of communication.
Wow.
Do you speak Bocce?
Very nice.
Of course.
It's like a second language.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So anyway, you hear a voice in giant speak call out from the north corridor. She's saying, "This way. Come this way. Hurry!
Who's there?
I don't have time to talk. Follow me quickly before more come."
mysterious voice.
Should we follow the plot?
In giant speak?
Oh, hey, look. Two metal bars leading that way on the ground.
Hold on, I need to shovel some more coal.
You boys know how to shovel coal? I didn't think this is what she meant.
Y'all can kiss my ass. We love you, John.
It's not your
fault. We love you from the bottom of our hearts.
Let's follow that.
Tonight's theme song, Crazy Train.
Thomas the Tank Engine.
Sure. Why not?
Alright. I guess we're all following that voice.
Choo-choo!
Yes, you're all following. So, when you go up towards the voice, you find out that it is indeed a female stone giant. And she is unarmed.
She has no arms? What the hell happened?
She's not carrying anything.
Holy shit!
She has her arms raised up and her palms out to show that she is no threat.
Theodore. Magic missile!
Theodore does a search for one of the seven magic stars. Stars?
Good. You know, back when I was doing SCA, anytime anybody was, I was fighting anybody and they would put their hands up like that, first thing I would do was stab their hand.
Jesus.
Yes, do you have a question?
So that's what I think of when people do this. I don't think I'm unarmed. I think, Target!
Oh no, he's channeling something. No, don't stop! Oh, he's waving more now! Hit him!
He's trying to dodge.
Anyway.
Can I shoot him in the hand?
She...
No!
She
this
gets
is why it's going to take us 2 years to get through this AP.
Yeah.
This
does
Theodora find a star?
She gets this weird look on her face when Theodora flies up under her robe like...
Oh my god.
But, yes, she does find another seven-pointed star carved into her back.
Shit, guys! We can't kill her!
Okay.
So... She starts speaking in common now. She goes, she says, I don't have much time, but know that if you are here to slay McMorrin, I am your ally. Come with me to a place where we can speak privately, for I would aid you in your quarrel here.
Shed's motive.
Yeah, that was, I mean, really. Just start saying your skill names, like...
Without my assistance, you might find only your graves below this place.
Wow,
33,
damn.
I read her mind.
She's not bluffing in any way. She is entirely serious with what she's saying.
Can I roll for a sense motive on the DM? Okay. Alright, then, I guess we should go with her.
Lead the way.
Will we have tea?
I do not know this tea.
Oh. I'll have to introduce
you
to tea.
You know, as in train.
What? I want to move
train.
You all up to here.
Whoa.
Railroad.
How is that tea?
That's not how tracks work.
It's like Sesame Street, where it's tea is for train.
Yeah.
Oh.
Tea is for train. As in we're being railroaded.
Geez.
C is for conductor.
C is for cookie.
He rides up front.
No, C is for cookie. You idiot. Have you ever seen Sesame Street?
I'm sorry! I'll pay closer attention next time.
Sesame I got Street. One illiterate fool!
I live and breathe Sesame Street.
Big Bird is my spirit animal.
Big Bird is, no, mine's a Snuffleupagus. No, mine's Gordon.
Gordon.
I think he's guy. Just the black guy in the neighborhood.
Who runs the runs the shop?
He's my spirit animal.
It is going to take us a long time to get through here. Anyway.
I'll impose a 5-minute silence on myself.
Ever since this group grew, it's going to be...
Let us come.
Anyway, the walls of this cave are painted with red, yellow, brown, and black figures, among which are apparent images of giants, mammoths, elk, deer, and wyverns. Others are harder to figure out. Ogres, perhaps, or giant children, or even humans. The dwarves are very clear, with beards and tiny axes being crushed under enormous giant feet. A simple oil lantern lights a small altar at the far end of the cavern. A modest offering of antlers, hooves, and patches of fur have been piled in front of this altar. Let's see. Now, as you, when you all gather into this place, each of you could swear that you're seeing the figures painted on the wall move in the corner of your eye, but when you go to look at it, it's perfectly normal.
What do we roll to see if we're high?
Sense motive on ourselves.
I'll go ahead and say that
probably a fortitude check or something.
I'll go ahead and say that there is a haunt trap in this area, but since you're with a certain stone giant, it's not being triggered. Instead, you're just seeing the paintings move in the corner of your eye. But anyway.
Creepy!
So what we need to do is hold our hand at the level of our eye.
No comment.
Fan of the opera? Anyone?
Yeah.
No.
Shoot.
You got it.
So she looks. She
I never
looks
understood
down,
that song though.
She looks down the two corridors, still looking a little nervous and rushed, and she goes, "Sorry, but we should be fine here. This is where McMorran took my husband, his old tribal leader, and flayed him to death. If you notice anything strange about the walls here, his spirit still haunts the place, so nobody but myself is able to come to this part of the cave."
Why are you helping us, and why hasn't McMorran dealt with you?
Why am I helping you? Simple. Because McMorran is a runt, a fool, somebody who should have been killed after his birth, yet managed to come back, take over our tribe, flay my husband to death in front of our tribe, and kept me alive just because he thought I meant no threat to him.
Well, I guess that's that, then.
I'm going to make tea.
Lucy, ask her about the snakes.
What about the snakes?
Are you crazy?
Ask her about the snakes.
What snakes?
Those snakes that you killed, so...
What's...
Talking about the lamia that we saw in the cave. The snakes.
Yeah, I saw snakes doing a ritual.
Oh, they're just praying to Lamatsu, as always. They're here to keep the dragons at bay.
Oh.
Yeah, there's two dragons that are held prisoner deeper in this cave. You probably want to avoid them.
It's a good thing
really?
Just run in.
No. Yes.
Prisoner?
Two red dragons. They'll kill anybody on sight.
How are they kept prisoner?
The Lamars use Char Monster on them. Constant. To a point where they don't even need to. They just willfully follow their orders.
That is horrible. We must free them.
I don't want to die.
We must free them.
Fair enough.
Listen.
Maybe they'd be grateful.
Yes.
Or bite our heads off.
They might be hungry.
That's a risk we'll have to take, not you, though.
Yeah.
I called one. Oh, yeah. We have Minotaur. He's good for at least one dragon.
Yeah.
I don't know. He's pretty spent already.
Listen.
He's about to be a fighter.
I know that...
Oh, my.
I know that you all have killed a few stone giants coming into here, and I cannot blame you for that. They are misguided. They are merely following the orders of their current tribe leader, who is McMorran, because it's either do as he says, or he takes them, and they come back changed, in a way.
What do you mean changed?
They have these runes all over their bodies, and they're kind of mindless, it, yeah. In a way.
It's legitimate.
They no longer care for their own independence. Yeah. They just do as they're told to the letter.
Do you have any idea of what sort of what they're doing to them? If there's any spell or anything? That
there is a powerful magic about it, but I have no idea where it came from or how it works. All I know is it enslaves their minds and slowly degrades their bodies as more and more runes slowly appear.
Master of Puppets, pulling your strength?
Yes. Sounds dubious.
We must free them!
I ask that from this point on, avoid killing stone giants. Defeat them if you must. But if you kill them, you're only doing what McMorran ultimately wants.
Why does he want to kill all of his own people?
You've noticed the stars on their bodies?
Yeah.
Their souls are linked to something. And when they die, it goes to where it's linked to. Their souls are fueling something. It has to do with the name Korzog.
We've heard that name before.
We've spoken with them before.
Have we spoken with them yet? No, we just heard him talking in the...
Yeah.
We came to a thing that it was, like, something he had said, and a message he was delivering, and something happened, and it got jacked up, and so now it's just on an infinite loop. And so we've heard his voice before, and we've kind of been getting little hints of who Korzog might be.
But he's probably bad.
We still don't know a whole lot about him yet.
Oh, okay. Alright.
I know Korzog supposedly is one of the ancient rulers of my people during the old empire. The rulers who enslaved us and forced us to build places like this, or the stairs, or the fortress above us. But that was so many centuries ago, they're merely stories by now. But I'm willing to believe that McMorran is under his spell, or maybe just his influence at least.
Is the tea done?
Is the tea done?
Aren't you the one making it?
Yes, the tea is done.
Are you talking to yourself?
she offers a cup of tea. A big cup of tea. She's a giant, right? So. Like a bowl of tea, but...
Like a big bowl.
So, do you believe what I say, or should I start walking away?
Are you going to do both?
What can you tell us about McMorran?
He spends his time in the libraries further below this cave. There is an ancient... Are you carrying your wayfinder? Is it visible?
Yes.
She looks at you.
Wayfinder. The Pathfinder Society all have a compass that's specific to the Pathfinder Society.
She looks to you and says, I know that thing that you're wearing. You're one of those society members, yes?
I am.
There is a place far below these caves that the people of your society would dream of getting their hands on. An ancient library filled with books and scrolls of the old empire.
The Dark Archive is gonna freak out, guys!
He spends most of his time down there, and nobody but myself is ever allowed to go down the tunnels that lead to that place. So, if you manage to make it to those tunnels, You should never have to worry about another stone giant again, save for McMorrin.
Hey, you should give us more help. 36.
Oh my god! Wow. Jedi mind tricking over here.
Tradition prevents me from aiding you in any fight against him, and it would prevent any of my followers from doing the same. However, let's see, what is she providing them?
You run interference?
Smokey and the Bandit?
Yes. Distract him! While we sneak in!
However, I can provide you with a map of the caves and answer any questions you may have about the rest of the caves that you haven't visited yet. Yes.
Will this map make the whole cave visible?
Yes.
Yes! Totally do that!
I will.
Video game shit.
Can we get a compass too so we can see where all the treasure is?
That would be awesome.
And the boss key.
And the special item that we need to kill the boss.
Yeah. Those are really hard to track down. And the boss door.
Yeah.
Motherfucking bookshop.
There you go. The whole map's been revealed.
Go through the dungeon, you find just a chest with like a lighter and kerosene in it. What do I have to do with this?
So she starts drawing out a map. She points out key points. The Lamars would always
Whoa.
Be...
Hold on, I'm trying to get it so that...
There we go. Will you fuck?
The Lamars are mostly always at their altar. They keep the dragons chained in a tunnel just north of them.
Good thing we didn't fly up there.
Down toward your best and less aggressive way to get to the library.
Don't care, next.
Is to go back south. And if you feel the need, there are dwarves being held prisoner in our armory.
Dwarves?
Dwarves?
Dwarves.
I heard armory.
Dwarves.
Dwarves?
Armory?
Yeah.
Armory?
Armory?
Oh!
So, yeah.
Wait. Hold on. I realize this is a little very important. But you don't see anything maybe inherently wrong with keeping prisoners right next to where you keep all the weapons? Nothing. Nothing at all.
Dear God,
They're kept crowded in a small cage next to the furnace, and their only job is to keep bellowing the fire.
Remember that rock?
So what you're saying is that you have one mercenary from this timeline in the armory fanning a rock.
What's he talking about?
Sorry, we've been
after the dragon.
He does this sometimes. He has anger issues.
They're kept cramped in a very small cave, bellowing a fire. They're entirely out of reach of any way to get out.
Wait, they're making the weapons for you?
No, they're just bellowing the fire.
Okay.
You know the...
I know what bellows are. I'm not a complete idiot.
We have ogres working the weapons. Oh. They just keep the fire nice and strong.
How many ogres are between us and all those weapons? I mean, those prisoners.
Scroll down for a
Can we weaponize the prisoners?
There would be two... There's two blacksmiths working the anvils, and there are three others in a cave next to them who will most likely hear any struggle that you create. So, basically, you have five people to get through to get to the tunnels.
I say we free the dragons first.
Oh my god.
I highly recommend avoiding the dragons.
Yeah, I don't think we want to deal with any more dragons. Remember the last one?
I think we should stay on this train.
One, there are two of them. Two, they are juvenile and strong. Three.
So they're stronger than the last one.
Yeah. Well, the last one was juvenile, too, actually.
Oh, was it?
No. Yeah.
Well, now there's two at once.
There's two of them. They're both red, so fire. They're completely under control of the Lamas, and if they get into any type of trouble, they'll, of course, come running to aid.
Are they guys?
Brother and sister.
Surprise, it specifies.
I'm okay with both.
You have a weird pet.
Weird sword out on the line and stuff.
Our mascot's kind of a freak.
I've noticed.
It's okay if they're dragons.
It's okay if they're dragons.
Not literally a dragon.
I can totally seduce the guy. The girl! I'll have to meet her.
Let me make you this promise. Let me make you this promise. You kill Mukmorin, it will automatically make me the tribal leader of the Stone Giants. And I will immediately leave this fortress with them and return to the Iron Peaks.
What are you going to do with the dragons?
Dragons can rot here for all I care.
We are freeing them!
Oh, no.
I do not like them.
Babe,
there is a warning signal going off. I assume it's still going. Probably.
Yes.
Man. Dude, forgot about that.
Yeah.
Oops.
Is there another way out of the library, or is there only one entrance and exit?
There is only one entrance and exit. But like I said, once you go down those tunnels, no one will dare follow. Under threat of death. And once Mukmorin is slain, they'll have to do whatever I say because I'm next in line.
And he didn't think you were a threat.
Absolutely not. Because again, tradition prevents me from taking up arms against our tribal leader.
Tradition sucks.
So what you're saying is...
Tradition is all we have.
If we beat this boss, we can't. We'll have free reign over the entire fortress, and we can do what we wish with it.
Well, I feel like getting to the boss is what we're going to go through this fortress for.
No, we bypassed it by going into
the fortress was up above. You guys are down in underground.
You know what I mean? The thing. The dungeon area.
So,
I do not like
green eggs
the idea of being trapped underground with all of the giants up above us, not knowing what they're doing. Would any of the tribes enter the fortress with their alarm going off?
The warning bells are only for this cave, only for these caves. Everybody up on the surface probably has no idea what's going on.
Can you turn off the bells?
If you're all willing to wait here for me to give some type of word that the intruders are gone or dead.
So we'll just hide in a locker until you radio HQ and your phone's all right.
What are you talking about, Stan?
This is your thing!
he does this sometimes.
I don't know what you mean, Stan.
What are the order of these buttons you're talking about? If you'll excuse
did you
me.
Say, did you say nerd?
No. No. So this here, pointing to the center, is this a way up into the fortress? And also a way down into the fortress for anyone who would want to pursue us.
Yes. It's a 30 foot pit with a winding tunnel that goes up. We toss animals down here and we let our champion fight them. It's all for good fun.
That's horrible.
He managed to slay a much younger dragon.
Oh no, I wouldn't tell her that. You made our druids sad.
Well,
her mom's a dragon.
Do away.
Her dad.
Her dad's a time dragon. completely fucks up the space crime continuum.
No, that's right. My
yeah,
dad.
I think you're getting people confused.
I don't know. All these dragons.
Perhaps we should go up and take care of anyone who might come behind us, or we could take the giant at her word and proceed to the library.
I'd rather just kill the boss and get this over with.
You're not allowed to say things like that.
Free the dragons!
Break the fourth wall.
Freedom for my people!
I'm trying to go check out the armory, but that's just me. Also, maybe securing some sort of escape wouldn't be a bad idea.
I mean, it's sort of like, you know, when you kill the boss at the end of, like, any dungeon in Ocarina of Time, like, somehow you teleport.
Get a blue warp teleporter?
Yeah, we get a blue warp.
I don't know if we should assume that will just happen.
Well, that's
yeah, what if it's like Metroid instead, and the whole thing just falls apart,
yeah, and you have to run out and escape?
No, the point is that once you kill the boss, like, she's gonna take all the enemies with her, and so it's like, okay.
So but not the Lamias!
No one gives a shit about that. So
I imagine that they'll dimension door away as soon as they hear of his death.
But will that just leave the dragons uncontrolled?
Yeah, but
no, they're chained up.
Yeah, which is why we should free them!
The whole rest of the fortress will be open.
We should wait to free them after the Lamians are out of the picture, because they have some sort of mind control on them. I think it would be better to wait and free them last. So that we can be gone out of the caves when they inevitably start breathing fire.
There are many tribes above us. You would be able to... You can only speak for your tribe, not the others.
Oh, that's true.
If the fortress is open, then perhaps they come after us.
Oh, no, because all those tribal leaders... are leaders that have either sworn an oath with McMorran, or were placed in charge by McMorran after he killed their previous tribal leader. So once McMorran is dead, they have no reason to stay here and no reason to go to war with the Lowlands. They'll eventually just leave. Yes.
Couldn't we just kill McMorran and then become the next tribal leaders?
No, only some giants can.
But
disguise person.
Okay.
If you say we may be giants, I'm smacking the back of your head.
I thought like the whole point though was like
that I can cast enlarge person. Would that count?
I thought the whole point was that McMorran wasn't even really a stone giant. He was just a guy.
Damn, you're one of the real giant.
McMorran is a stone giant. He is a runt, though. I forget what this is. Stone giants reach, like, 7-8 feet tall. McMorran is only 6.5.
They're taller than that.
Yeah, I thought they'd be way taller than that.
Why?
He'd probably be about 9 feet tall.
Why is he so formidable? What makes him so formidable?
Stone giants are so much larger. McMorran is like a dwarf of stone giants. He's so small that he would have been thrown out as an infant. However, he had a touch of magic. Magic is a very important thing to us stone giants because it's something that traces back through our heritage to the times that we were enslaved by the wizards. Stone giants become sorcerers. Sorcerer stone giants are heralded by their tribe, so that was the one thing that saved McMorran. But it turns out he wasn't a sorcerer. He did not have innate magic powers. He had to study to perform his magic. That made him an outcast. That got him thrown out.
God, they sound like Republicans.
Because
you study and you get thrown out of society.
To us stone
giants, I hate education.
Yeah, to us stone giants, a wizard's way of casting spells is not the same as a sorcerer's way of casting spells. He was thrown out, he came back a year later, suddenly with all this power, and here we are now.
Sounds like he made a dubious pact.
perhaps we should move quickly.
Yeah, I think we should go with Stanton's idea and go just find him and take him down. But if you are still worried about people coming from behind...
Barricade the doors!
Maybe we could do something like that. I don't know how.
Giant pit.
Yeah, I don't know. Can you dig a hole?
Aren't you a little short to be giant guard?
Oh, it's the uniform.
Oh, uniform!
My tribe is the tribe that resides inside the fortress.
I rooted Stonewall.
The other tribes from entering the fortress walls.
Alright, that works too. That was very convenient.
I see we head back down south. Free the prisoners. And then move on.
Free the dragons!
Oh.
You know
not
what?
Those prisoners.
You go ahead and do that. We'll take care of the dwarves.
Please not yet. Don't give her any ideas.
Theodorus starts to fly away. And Lucy grabs her tail and pulls back. No! No! Do not tell her that!
Alright, dwarf time. We get to go see your armory.
Dwarf time. Minidus looks at Lucy and says, "You talk?"
Damn.
Wait, who are you? Where am I?
She doesn't know how to respond to that.
Crap, there's a sixth member of the group?
Wait, is that where all those lightning bolts have been coming from?
I just thought it was summer.
I just thought it was heat lightning.
She kind of opens and closes her mouth, and Theodore is like, "That is right, she is my familiar!" No.
Perhaps we should move on.
We're all down here now.
Okay. Oh no, you left someone! Oh wait, no, that's a giant.
My apologies, I have a low charisma score.
No, you don't. It's only seven.
Seven.
What is it?
His charisma score is 7.
Wait, you want to lead a nation with a charisma score of 7?
It's fine, he can just stack belts and stuff.
Big Boss started his own country and he's like pretty much autistic.
It's alright, I know how to stack belts.
Yeah, look how that ended.
Besides, he has a family name to go off of.
I can easily get my charisma up to 26 if I have the gold too.
Charisma, what?
Wait, what?
What's that? What are you talking about?
What are
about?
All these numbers you're talking about?
Man, you have the same charisma I do.
Menendez is going to be like George
Menendez
W. Bush.
Menendez has such an exceptionally high intelligence that he understands that we're in a game.
Wait,
so you're Deadpool?
Yes.
Does that say core rulebook?
Okay, I have seen the true gods, and they determine our fate.
Menendez is going to give his first speech in front of the entire nation, be nervous as all hell when he sees all the eyes looking at him. They're like, "This dude sucks as a public speaker." Yeah, but his family name, dude. Can't go against that.
Right.
Please tell me he pisses his pants in front of the crowds.
My first order of business.
He wouldn't,
he wouldn't get
nervous in front of the crowd. He's just... He grew up in solitude, basically. He was raised by dwarves who don't talk a whole lot, even to themselves. So, he just hasn't had a whole lot of social interaction.
So he could get
I was
there,
raised
like,
by talkative dwarves.
Hi.
They wouldn't stop saying hi-ho.
Okay, bye.
So anyway, you all head back south.
To the dirty, dirty south. Because that's where the kitchen is.
Is that the Power Rangers community?
Yeah, that was me.
Cue up.
Someone's texting me. It's Zordon, leave me alone!
I'm busy.
Zordon, you cockblock! I was just about to kiss under the mistletoe!
I'm trying to roleplay.
Oh, I'll leave you alone then.
No, not that kind.
So anyway, when you all start going through this tunnel, you smell... Let's see.
Beer
vinegar, rotting hair, and much worse stuff.
Dwarves?
Yeah. Boba Fett?
Boba Fett? Where?
What does Boba Fett smell like?
He smells like stomach acid.
Theodora, you know that. Theodora would know that the smell is coming from this tunnel.
It's coming from there.
Just a whole bunch of rotten, nasty stuff.
My loot senses are tingling.
Ryan, look me up.
What the hell?
I'm helping. I'm trying to play a game here.
I'm trying to run a game here. I think I feel.
All right. The party got distracted by shiny.
You're the one who recruited
things.
The group. You did.
Yes.
Just saying.
Yes.
You guys run down that tunnel.
All right. Let's do this.
Anyway, when you go past that tunnel, it reeks of vinegar, rotting hair, and worse. And a single large stone basin sits in the middle of the room, about 10 feet square. And filled with foul-looking fluid, upon which float patches of wet fur.
Oh, God.
Around the basin stand a dozen wooden frames, over which leather and hides are stretched. At the far end of the cave, a stinking mound of hide and fur awaits tanning. See, there's three ogres in there tanning fur and hide.
Oh, that's just terrible.
And you can probably just imagine how horrible that would smell.
They're tanning it, huh?
Yep.
So, remember what we did earlier with the fire?
What did we do with the fire? Start it?
The fireball?
Hey, we didn't start the fire.
Oh.
Yeah!
Been burning since the world's been turning?
And down the next tunnel is a room with walls that have been chiseled away to and made almost regular. Four anvils stand in the middle of the room, while to the south burns a bright forge fire. Immense bellows stand near a row of low iron cages, each featuring a filthy mound of straw. The bellows handles extend through the cages, allowing anyone imprisoned within to work the bellows without the necessity of leaving their confines. To the north, mounds of steel and broken and bent pieces of dozens of weapons remain working. Now, if you hadn't been told that there were dwarves in those cages, you would almost think that they weren't, because they had their beards shaved off. Oh, and no. From the looks of their faces, it was not done willingly.
Aw, they're just so tiny people.
Dwarves lose their beards and they become invisible?
Yes.
Why don't they shave more often?
That sounds awesome. Exploitable. I'm a dwarven rogue. No one suspects a thing. They think I'm just a child.
I switch my race. Stan's been a dwarf the whole time.
They just think I'm a fat child.
No, his stealth is just that good. Alright, so you said the dwarves are in that room with the ogres.
But yeah. If we don't
there's
take
no way
out
to, like, free them and be sneaky, maybe?
No, not really, especially since they're standing next to a large fire pit.
Hey, the flaming bowl of fire.
Yeah.
If we put it and keep it right here, it could serve as a choke point if we want to hit the blacksmiths first and then come back for the tainters.
Well, that's a good idea. Don't you also have that other firewall spell, too? Or the ring, or something?
Yeah.
The burning ring of fire!
Turn on the burning ring of fire! Burning ring of fire!
Is there something flammable in the process of tanning leather?
You mean all the methane given off by the shit? Yes.
That's what I meant by
fire snake.
Let's just breathe fire
into
that whole room.
Feet long.
Fire snake?
Yeah.
What the hell?
That's amazing. Just cast that shit in the tunnel, and we'll go fight those blacksmiths.
Fire snake?
I've never
heard of
that.
That's
amazing.
Fire snake. It's 55 feet long, and it does 11d6 damage. It's in the advanced book.
Man, that thing's huge.
Wow.
Spooky snake fire.
But it's 55 feet long.
Yeah, like, that's enough snake.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm getting range 60 feet.
Oh, no, it's even longer.
Range shape is desired. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
Can you turn into, like, a giant pretzel?
Just send it out.
Effect. Yeah. Let's see, the fire snake affects 1 5-foot square per caster level, and each square must like be adjacent to the previous square, starting with you.
Just make a zigzag pattern in that tunnel.
Creatures in the path of the fire snake take 1d6 points of fire damage per caster level. So, it would have to start from where she stands. It goes in a straight line, but she's able to draw it any way that she wants.
How long does it last?
Let's see, casting time. What? Duration instantaneous. So, actually, she does it, it and moves, then and then goes away.
Yep. So we couldn't just set it.
But she gets to do 11d6 points of fire damage to anybody within a 5-foot square of the line of fire.
How about you cast something like the wall, and then when they all approach the tunnel, you cast that on them.
Yeah, and just trap them.
And, yeah, we can fight those guys, and someone else can stay back.
Maybe you could tank them so that they all get, like, congested, and then you can run away and we can blast it.
You want him to get a stuffy nose?
What?
There.
Oh, congested in the tongue.
Oh,
yeah, choke they'll point. Die from the cold.
Choke point there. Draw them out to there. Do the catch all 5 of them with the snake.
Ooh.
Do that.
Couldn't they just run back somewhere?
I mean, well, I could but just, I could fire a
they
shot.
Think, they would think that, yeah, like you fire a shot, you go and
throw your sword.
Or something, you know.
How about I go up one of the opposite tunnels and come at them from behind?
They'll think that they're only fighting, you know, 2 guys.
And then we'll run.
Fire snake as soon as they're in range.
It'll be just like that scene from A New Hope. Where Han Solo chases a stormtrooper down the tunnel and then he comes out.
Fire snake.
And then they cast fire snake on him. And then Han Solo died.
I remember that. That was a good scene in The New Hope. The special, special edition.
The one where Greedo actually does shoot him.
Yeah. No, he has fire snake.
Where all the guns get replaced by walkie-talkies and all the stormtroopers are Ewoks.
So, what if we had Menendez and Snake over here?
Call me Plissken.
Plissken. I don't give a damn about your prison.
I give a fuck about your war.
Yeah. So what if we have Sneaky McSneakerson and the guy who can cast invisibility over here?
I mean, if they see us run down the other tunnel, then it's not like they're gonna go that way.
Well, stay over here and we draw them.
Big dumb giants, ogres.
Unless they know something we don't.
Yes.
Yeah.
So basically, Kurt and Menendez over here. Everyone else. Over here.
Farther back so that we can use that choke point.
Yeah, how about...
Well, we have a bunch of area of effect stuff.
Yeah, because you can channel.
Yeah.
Big mean.
I can channel a bunch of spells. He can sling a bunch of spells. Or you can just charge in if you want to. I'm really leaving it up to you.
Yeah.
You're running low, though.
But we could just murder everyone in the whole
thing. Yeah, I'm going to save for...
Yeah, don't forget your resources.
Yeah. I mean, you can probably
also,
do martial stuff, too, right?
Yeah.
A lot of my bigger stuff, like the fire snake, that's 55 feet I have to work with.
Yeah.
I don't want to hurt any of you guys.
Yeah, that's...
And
we'll be fine. I can roll acrobatics.
Oh, my God. That's a bad idea.
I can.
If,
I can jump over it.
If we're going through the choke point, I'd have more
I have really good reflex.
Room to work with.
Yeah, I was thinking all the way to the left there, in that more open room, we could have Lucy there.
Yeah.
And... we could lead the stupid ogres into that little tunnel space so they could be bunched up, and we can just, you know, stand behind her. And then we can move in front when she's done.
Yeah.
And you can channel your fun things while we're doing it.
And yeah, keep it there.
It'll all be great. It's going to be great. It's going to be great. Hopefully it'll work.
It's only in games like this you can imagine the main characters of a show just standing there going, I want to do this, no, God, do this.
Yeah, we're just like looking at him like, what are they doing?
We're
in a circle.
And in action movies, they typically brush over that by just having like the character be like, I have a plan.
And then it just cuts.
And then we cut to, like, the bad guys walking into the trap. Like, yeah. If you actually followed them, it would be boring.
But really, they had, like, three stupid ideas, like, hiding under mammoths.
And it took them 50 minutes to do.
Yeah.
Alright.
And then they're finally like, you know what, let's just punch Phasma in the face, because that's what everyone's been waiting to see.
whenever you guys have a plan down packed and everything, let me know, and just for sake of sanity, we'll spring it in a surprise round, and then initiative from there, if that sounds good.
We could just stick everybody back here, and everybody who can just cast spells, and then we can stick to fighters right here.
Yeah, we need someone to lure them, like, actually out.
Can lure them out.
Alright. Sure you don't want to get a good old sneak attack on them? You'd probably do a lot of damage.
I don't think he doesn't have sneak attack.
Yeah. Oh. I mean, not every class has a sneak attack.
Well, I know who we can use as our bait.
The mascot. That has wings.
Oh, we were going with Theodora? Not Kurt?
Alright. Oh, I mean, if you want, I
could
shoot.
I could shoot too. I could help.
I feel like you would rather want to be the one that isn't seen, so you can get your sneak bonus in.
Why don't you get a sneak bonus like my first shot? Because it's going to start out the surprise round. And everything's flat-footed to me in the surprise round.
Okay, then.
And it's a sneak attack, so it's flat-footed.
Alright, I mean, Theodora can fly real fast.
So you wanna get the tanning guys or the anvil guys?
Both. Ooh. Have a straight shot down to the tanning guys, and everybody would probably come running.
Yeah, we just need to get all of their attention. Somebody belch really loud.
I can do that!
Theodora.
Let me chug
an ale.
Yeah, let me chug an ale. She starts chugging an ale.
Alright, so we're...
And Lucy's like, oh! She runs.
Okay.
Into position.
Menendez is apparently running off to the privy. Where does everyone else want to be?
Just put me, like, smack dab in, like, the range of the big, stupid guy.
Like?
The hill giant. Or the
Well, you like, want to you want to get like, both
you
wanna, sides.
Do you want to start off shooting them, or do you want to wait till the battle starts and then get, like, a sneak attack while everyone's...
Yeah, that's why I didn't want you to be the one to get their attention. Why would you do that when you can shoot them if they run out here? We need someone to stand in the middle there and yell really loud or bang some shit together.
I think me shooting one of their friends would get their attention.
That could probably
crossbows don't make a bunch of noise.
Yeah, but
no, but I'm
getting shot by an arrow and going, "Oh fuck, I've been shot." Well,
very true. So.
Why did I bring these pots and pans if I'm not going to use them?
Because you're a woman. Oh.
Oh no!
Did you just say?
Come here, I'll cook you an omelet. Could be the last one you ever have.
Oh, right, sexist.
Yeah. That is I am the sexist!
Alright.
I made the sexist joke!
Alright, so you're gonna be the one who... You're gonna be our show starter, right? Alright, so we'll leave you there.
I thought I was gonna belch!
Not right now.
Can I shoot? And, like, as I hit him, you just, like, belch super loud.
Okay!
Alright, so, Theodora, you don't leave...
It's back. Gets shot in the back. What the hell was that? What's up, guys?
Alright, so Theodora, you don't need to be with...
Menendez teaches Kurt how to say, "What's up, guys," in giant.
What's up?
By the way, when you all have a chance, go to your It's a guy who people submit their best D&D moments to, and he does them in a quick comic form.
The gazebo. I ever heard the gazebo story?
I submitted him the one of, it's everything's okay! I'm waiting for him to get back to me on that. But anyway.
Long story short, a player didn't know what a gazebo was. So as the DM's describing it to him, the player's like, what color is it? It's white. It's a gazebo. I shoot an arrow at it.
What? It's like a creature.
Well, there's a demon that sounds similar to gazebos. That's probably what it was.
Gazebo.
Gazelbabum.
Anywho,
a gazebum.
He's ready to let loose. All
right, you don't need to be with Team Showstarter. So do you still want to be, or do you want to be back with Team Let's Fuck Everything Up?
I already drank the ale!
But if sound is going to travel in the cave, you don't need to be with Team Showstarter.
She goes off to the sneak team and starts perfect. Good job, you asshole! You ruined our plan!
Can we do that just for, like comic value?
I like fucking things up!
Alright. I'm with Team Fucking Things Up.
Okay. We need to get Lucy back there, too.
First. Yeah, make sure no one's in front of me, because this is going to be hot. And I can run back after it's done.
Effie, I'm assuming you want to be with Team Fuck
this
Everything
is
Up.
Be hot. Yeah.
That's what she said!
Wait, don't you have Pots and Pans to
play?
I don't have Pots and Pans, unfortunately.
Holy shit!
Ah!
No!
Oh, no!
Everyone screamed.
Alright, so Menendez, do you want to be with Team Fuck Everything Up, or do you want to be with Team Stab Him in the Back?
That Team Fuck Everything Up.
Team Fuck Everything Up.
Yeah,
Wild Man Team.
It's going to be bad if they just turn around and decide to attack only you.
This is a solo sneaking mission, I'll be fine.
You know what that would be great is if they run the other way, away from the ambush we set up.
And then I'll chase them like, ah!
By the way, that's not you. Roll20's been having issues lately.
Oh.
Okay.
How far away am I?
I'm doing fine. I don't have the red box.
How far away am I from the...
Will you?
You can get there. How far away am I?
Click that link.
You're about one move away from
60 feet.
Yeah, rushing.
Yeah, if you double move, you could probably kick him in the balls.
Yeah, but you want to get the attention of all of them.
Yeah.
So that's the demon that looks like gazebo. Oh yeah.
Glarbazer.
Glorbazer.
Oh,
shit, it looks awesome.
That's not white.
That is not white.
That down there in the bottom is a human size.
Oh.
Yeah.
It was an albino one.
Is that a codpiece?
No, it's his.
Or is demon. That... He doesn't need a dick.
That's just what his looks like.
Because it's about as big as the human. Just that area.
He's a demon. He doesn't need a dick.
It's ribbed for her pleasure.
it's spined for her torture.
That's, well, yeah.
Hey, some girls are into that.
Who? Where?
They're all dead, though. Oh.
Yeah, that would happen.
Most of them die.
Yeah.
How many women do you know that love to shove barbed wire?
Some of them survive, and they have tieflings.
Oh, boy.
Ah.
You'd be surprised.
That explains it.
Yeah.
Let's play the game.
Shut up.
Oh, fuck.
Get out!
This is art appreciation, you dick.
And then,
anywho.
And then there's...
I thought that was the dick.
And then there's looking up random Teen Titans stuff on DeviantArt and coming across one where, you know, a Raven and Beast Boy ship, but...
Hey, John, we're trying to play a game.
Yeah?
Did you draw this?
No.
Could you stop interrupting?
Oh! You lose 50 experience points.
You lose 50 HP.
Alright, is your all's plan ready?
Yes!
Aside from the glaring flaw going off to the right, I think we're okay.
So don't go off to the right.
Yeah, don't go off to the right.
Just run back to my friend.
Yes.
Menendez is gonna play checkpoint.
You're gonna get hit by a fire snake.
I mean, we're gonna
run back. You control it around
you. Yeah, we'll have some time.
Okay.
All right. You want to move up so that you
Yeah, in fact, maybe Lucy should move up a little bit.
Yeah, move up, like, right next to him, actually.
All right, are you ready? Fire shot.
Well, the whole point is that the fighters should be in the front to flank him if they come through.
She'll run back after she casts.
My house.
All right.
I need dice.
All right, are we all ready?
But we don't. If you're retreating, we don't want that corner being blocked up by all the fighters behind you. So,
if we stick,
what?
No, I forgot.
There's only a limited
amount. I'm gonna have to here. Then she can send it from here out.
I'm gonna have to get in there.
So put her right,
like where she's where she was at.
Okay.
But another fighter there. So like Theo.
North of her would be whoever else is gonna
take the front.
Yeah.
Or Effie.
Or
taking the front now. Theo can like fly over.
What if we put Theo back here so that she covers, so that she cut him off if they try to go anyway? That way she can attack him from the back. We're attacking him from the front. Close him between us. Close him between the two forces.
But she's gonna belch.
Good God!
She's gonna belch.
Don't break his dice case.
It's fine. We'll leave her. We'll leave her back.
It'll be okay.
It's all fucked up.
No, I just dropped them.
Alright, take the shot.
I'm taking the shot.
Shoot her!
Oh, I study him.
Okay.
Oh my god.
It's very helpful.
You study him and find out that he is indeed a giant.
He's an ogre. He smells bad.
He smells even worse since he's tanning hides right now. Ugh. Ugh. They're all singing a song in giant.
Giant song, giant song, tanning hides, giant song.
That's a good one. What is?
Help me. What are you looking for?
You should help me figure this out.
What?
Joe, please.
Yeah.
Which one is my actual one? Because this says carried, but it has like a way bigger like attack button. But then this is, like, it says this is the one that's, like, in my, being held.
Why do you have three?
I don't know, it just messes.
It would
screw it up.
Like, that one is way too high.
Yeah.
It wouldn't be
that, like, stacked with just plus one.
Oh, that's just bonus. It could be that.
Have you been using the wrong crossbow?
No,
because that wouldn't be...
I think, yeah, because with my...
You wouldn't have that, because that would... You'd have to be, like... I don't know, if they're full... Even if you were full B&B class, you'd have to have 12 to be able to use that, level 12.
Be able to get what?
You would get all three. So maybe that's your full round attack. If you have... What's your base attack bonus? Should be probably up above it.
That's my CMB. Oh, here it is. Plus 11.
Oh, yeah. So you get three attacks. So, yeah, that first one is the one you would use, that top one, in a full round action.
Oh, okay.
And then, that's what you need to be looking at.
Oh.
So that, in a full round action, you get all three of those shots.
Oh, so I get a plus 16 shot, a plus 11 shot, and a plus 6 shot.
Yep.
And so what are these then? Just extra things I get? Oh, from the plus one
from the plus one, yeah.
Okay, so that is right then.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
You ready to fire?
Yeah, and I'll actually...
It's begun!
Yes,
that's the Adora's job!
You'd only be able to use the one, but it would... Or the first one.
That works.
First
one, yeah, since it's the first round. Alright.
It reverberates throughout the room.
Belch! What's that? I don't know, but whoever it is did a good job.
Benedez. Needs to be 5 feet away from people.
Is that his character flaw?
Y'all won't like me very much.
Does
yes, actually. Well, Benedez casts a spell. And these four mithril blades he has attached to his belt come off of it and start spinning around him.
Nice.
That is so pretty!
He's Virgil now.
So...
Does a 31 hit him?
Yeah, 31 hits him.
Great.
So this guy right here gets struck by the bolt. He's like, "Ah, motherfucker!"
And I say, "What's up, guys?"
Hey, everybody.
Can you roll for damage?
Yeah, roll for damage. Best small human hit me with a crossbow. Let's get him and tan his skin.
Okay, so I do 5 regular.
Did you add your bonus?
Stop making fun of me and then the sneak dice.
All ogres are wimps!
Who said that?
What was that voice?
What is that? Preference. How do you add? 13, so, yeah. 13 plus 5, so
18. HQ, respond!
This is HQ.
Alright, so... alright, so these three are going to start running in your direction.
You're enough.
What about the other ones?
The other ones kind of yell down the hall, "What's going on out there? Human! Human!"
Nothing, nothing's wrong.
So
we're all fine here now. How are you?
So they all drop their hammers and they start running
as well. That's what they call it.
Drop their hammers? Oops. They drop their hammers and then put down their mallets.
Alright, so...
Oh, man!
Alright, so still in the surprise round, what's going on?
You're running the fuck out of there.
Yeah.
You need to run, son.
I'm leaving.
The rest of you should probably start channeling something. Something
terrible. I'm holding action until they are all... in that room. Or...
Hello.
As close as possible.
I want the fucking thing.
Can I, like, do the super peel-out, like, Sonic the Hedgehog, so I'm ready to, like, dash at them really fast?
Hey, can you...
Yeah.
Can you move...
40 feet? Yes.
Can you only move your... Oh, you can move 40 feet.
Because I got special boots.
Can you move double your speed... If it's a surprise round, like you're running, or...
Can I do that?
Can you only move, like, your standard?
I don't think I have...
I was more or less asking him, because he's the one who knows this.
Oh.
No, we make the rules.
Basically, can he make it back here?
Sure.
Alright.
Yay!
Hey, you're back! Yeah.
Oh, hey, I forgot to add my +3 from study target to damage, so it would be 21.
Okay.
Sorry.
Charging.
Can't retroactively damage you.
Charging.
Okay,
you just
so...
bled out a little bit.
Charging.
I guess I'm also going to just, you know,
wait. Okay, that... Is that
I don't think you can reach them all if you do it from here. Wait one more.
Okay. One more.
Can you hit the other ones, though? In the back?
Yeah.
So you roll out your fire snake?
Yeah.
All right.
It goes in a circle, kind of around here. Can I... I'm going to stand up first. And then I'm going to walk over here. And then I'm going to steal this.
Maybe. And then I'm
going to leave. So do you know how you're going to get back in your car yet?
I gotta drive Chapin home, then drive to his place, and then drive him back down here so he can get his car.
What? What?
John is going to drive me to my house after dropping you off to pick up a key, an extra key, and then drive back here.
Okay. Whoosh!
Beautiful snake.
Okay.
You knew?
That's one of the government's most secret black projects.
35.
Are you gonna channel anything?
So.
Stanton's channeling Eat Doritos right now.
That's a very effective spell.
Gives him the energy I'd only be able to
actually hit the
I didn't
top
have
green.
Dinner yet.
So. Huh?
Yeah, because it can only you can only draw it out 60 feet, so it would pretty much stop right here.
Right where?
Right where the arrow is. Yeah, right where the arrow is.
Yeah.
Oh well.
What?
If we waited for them to get a bit because closer you can and engage our fighters, you could use it to hit them all.
Okay.
Fire Snake has a range of 60 feet, and it can only go. You can only draw it out 60 feet. So once it hits the 60-foot mark, that's as far as it can go.
Oh. So I wait a little bit longer.
We're using theoretical physics. It's okay.
What?
Theoretical length.
String theory?
Yes.
That's snake theory?
They're not all going to be able to get in any closer than that anyway, so 3 is probably all you're
going
to be able to
Yeah, do. So I'm going to roll 3 reflex saves because they get reflex for half.
Still the surprise round? Yes, it is. No.
Yeah.
Yes, it is. We haven't rolled initiative.
I'll roll initiative. I didn't even know that was supposed to be,
but feel free, I guess. We'll have to eventually.
So, let's see. The ogres got a 15 and 20.
20? No.
Alright. Then the one stone giant who got caught won't make it either. So go ahead and roll your 11d6.
That's so, that hurts.
I have 6 here.
Way. Here's one more.
7.
Whoa, numbers!
26 that I said?
17 plus 26?
Yep.
Wow.
Oh.
That's like a...
43.
It's amazing.
Is there a class that can attack with dice?
I love the gambler.
The gambler?
That's Dragon's Glove. Or Dragon Glove.
What?
The gambler. Isn't that a class?
In what?
The Dragon Glove.
No. I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
It's not?
Alright.
There
he
is.
Anybody else?
And then I step back.
Anybody else doing anything for the surprise round, or should we go straight to initiative?
I was gonna say, is it like that?
So you could you they usually use cards, but you could use dice.
Anyone else?
Doing
for surprise
what?
Round?
Anything? I'm gonna hold a power attack vital strike and just wait if I can do.
Would yeah. Theodora want to move up to close the gap?
Yeah.
She would want to stand next to...
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
...the disc, so...
So she's hovering in the air, like, above everyone.
Maybe, Stanton, you should move forward so you can hit him more with your radius.
What do you mean?
Channel negative energy.
Maybe we should... split up?
That's always a good idea.
Spin.
Let's spin and play.
Because that's a good trend.
We could set it a little differently, because currently, all of the squares around Minidez are, have blades spinning in them.
Oh, boy. I'd better roll an acrobatics check. Wait, how many, oh, you, that's no. Your blade circle.
Wreath of blades is what it's called.
What's
is
the
that...
radius on it?
5 feet around me.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, I was gonna say, we're fine.
We're safe.
Yeah, you just can't step up into the choke point.
Alright, let me roll.
So I hope Effie has a ranged weapon.
I can throw my
you
sword.
You can throw your sword. Can I just start carrying, like, hand crossbows and just, like, pass them out when we need them?
Yeah, if we can hit anything. I don't have anything in crossbows.
Well, I think, like, most people at least begin play with sling. So that when push comes to shove, you have at least the most bare bones ranged attack.
You're a fighter. You're proficient in any weapon imaginable, except exotic weapons. It's just that when you use a ranged weapon like a crossbow, it would be your dexterity feeding into attack, not strength.
That would be embarrassing.
I think with something like a sling, though, you use your dexterity for attacks, but you use but you can apply your strength to damage.
If you buy a bow, like a composite bow, you can cast.
Well, I don't think Effie can cast anything.
Yeah, it's a, have it enchanted. It's adaptive. It'll adjust to your strength. So, like, you could get it if you buy a composite longbow. You can get a composite longbow with a +2. It's that's just basically the strength of it, and but that's the most you could do. Even if you have a +4 to strength, you'd only be able to manage that +2. But if you have adaptive, it adjusts to that +4 that you would be able to add to. So that might be something to look into.
So, Stanton, what's your initiative?
He refuses to roll. Oh my god. You jerk.
How am I going before the fighter?
Kurt.
Wait, the line is on the bottom of the number, right? On a dice?
Yeah. Yes.
Wow!
I'm really smart. I got a 15.
Okay.
I'm really smart.
Effie, you got the 17, I guess? Yep.
You did this last time, too. You went before, like, three other people.
The leading player.
He went before Menendez. Hey, what's Menendez?
29.
That'll work.
Low
roll. Lucy's.
9.
Oh my god.
Theodora, the hero of Sandpoint, and Lucy's just kind of there.
Lucy takes it down.
My,
Menendez, you're up.
Menendez will cast.
Are you gonna cast something?
No.
Maybe.
He's just pretending.
So long.
I just don't want you to use up all your stuff.
Yeah.
So long. And thanks for all the fish.
Hold his action until they get close enough to hit him. Then he's going to step up to them and attack.
Alright.
Good idea.
Stanton.
Wait, let me guess. Channel negative energy.
No.
It would be a waste right now.
What are they carrying?
No, you fucking prick. I'm casting bless.
Weapon wise.
That's my other thing I do, idiot.
The
+1.
Let's see, the ogre fighters are using the ogres are using their ogre hooks. The stone giants are not carrying anything with them.
Okay.
So they're just gonna use their slam attacks.
We're gonna get ram.
What's
slam.
What's Stanton doing?
Bless.
Blessing.
Okay. You're all.
I'll do it. Yes,
I bless you all, I bless you all, my children, in the name of Abadar. In the name of justice.
That's Friday night.
How much would your blades hurt?
Oh,
me
not if I did step in them.
When you start your next turn in them, it would be 5d6.
But they don't hurt me if I just go in their range.
You can pass through.
Oh. You just can't stand in them, right?
Yep.
I'd say just wait and let them get at the choke point. Because if they engage you, then the Reaper Blades will do us no good.
Because I don't want to run up to them and have them all beat the shit out of me while everyone watches. I guess I'll just hold Improved Vital Strike, Power Attack.
Alright, Kurt. Right now you got a rock wall blocking any line of sight.
Yeah. I was gonna maybe move, like...
Stick your hand around the corner.
Like, in the square that's adjacent to Lucy and Theodora. Because that would give me a clear line of sight.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'll just do that. And, Oh, that was my move, actually. Crap.
Yeah, too bad.
That was your move action. You can
see. I mean, I'm assuming it's going to take several rounds to kill them.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so I'll just go ahead and shoot them.
Or wait, first round of combat, never mind.
Oh, sorry.
Lucy!
I'm home.
Oh.
Get it, Lucy?
Like I love you.
Yeah, you get it.
I got it. Remember the one that ate the chocolates?
Flame Spear?
Woohoo! I guess you're closing up the choke point with it?
Yeah.
Oh, be careful not to...
Well, I want to, like, roll it into them.
Okay.
You bowling with fire again?
Yep.
I love it. We're gonna get
goodness
to the boss.
Goodness gracious.
We're gonna get the mug and he's balls. Gonna just step on us.
Y'all are a bunch of gimpy fighters. It's like...
Alright, so the one gets to roll his reflex save since it's rolling already. Are you making it roll through them or just up to one?
Up to one.
Okay.
Do you remember, like, the...
For now.
Like, the meme to, like, the...
Okay,
one team like, someone summoning a fire 11.
I guess an 11's not high enough.
Like, no.
Alright, roll your damage.
Okay, and that's...
Like, Al Gore summons a fire.
3d6.
Just say, God, how many years ago was that?
Really? I wish I didn't load my computer up with viruses.
10?
It's fine. Yeah, it's gonna be great.
What loaded your computer with viruses?
YTMND.
YTMND.
You're the man now, dog.
Hey, what's the Theodore gonna do? Just wait her.
Punch the case for
pots. Yeah, right. She'll wait.
Alright, so it's...
Hold action.
Alright, so the stone giants... This one is going to push his way through all the guys in front of him and be like, get out of the way, you stupid ogres! I'll show you how to take down a human!
Oh my god, a giant sun!
Let's see, what's their move?
There's a miniature sun in my tunnel.
Oh my god.
Where would it show? Oh, there
really?
It is. Speed, 40 feet.
I was going to say, don't we know that? Speed.
Well, he can't charge anyone, but he's going to at least come
to here. It is.
Is he going... He's going through the
fireball. Yeah, he's going through the fireball, so he's going to make a reflex. He only got a 15.
Nope. 11.
Okay.
And Benedez is going to take that attack that he was waiting for.
All right.
Step up. Oh, can you... I don't know. Can you step up into his range at this point, or are you just going to hit him?
It's a nat 1, so...
Nat 1's
oh my god.
Yep. Runelords missed!
But he rolled a 20!
That one's an automatic fail though. Okay, their turns.
What?
Cardboard box.
No!
Can't believe you missed.
This guy's like, oh my god, wait. I'm on fire! And he's
I never use
kill.
These.
Huh?
I never use these.
Going back in time. I hope you get a 20 now.
Retcon.
Oh my god! How is that even possible?
1 in 400
That's a, what in the hell?
Menendez got 2 ones in a row.
If you roll another one, I'm gonna scream.
By the rules of probability, he should
have rolled a 2! You rolled a 2!
Oh my god!
I feel like you deserve a hero point just for that.
Did you do something to this website?
What AC do we have to be?
I'm like a 24.
I mean, I could just look off your screen.
A 22?
Are you kidding me? Nah. You want to use your next one?
can I sponsor his reroll? I got like 6. I have no reason why.
Fine. Alright.
We're cheating super hard. I didn't like that roll. I didn't like it again.
Hey,
there we go.
Yay!
And hey!
You need to put
what?
Your face in Abadar.
That's...
Holy
by
shit.
The gods
crit.
Huh?
Crit range! Crit range! Alright, reroll it!
28. Welcome to our campaign where 28. We reroll until we get a crit.
Welcome to Wednesday Pathfinder where the rules are made up, but the points don't matter.
That's right. Points are just like Canada.
All the stupid shit and time wasting always makes is always worth it because we get all these rerolls from
it. Exactly.
An arcane
we are
point.
Playing the game.
Alright.
Just for being assholes.
How many of those do you have? Six left now.
We're not so like, the points don't matter. Be... That's right, the points are just like 4th edition. No longer matters.
Oh, man.
Let's see, so that was just a crit. Quit so... clicking.
Depending on how much you're adding, you might as well just say he's dead.
Okay, it's ruined.
Just when I was getting into it.
My bonuses?
Feeling the dance.
My bonuses are higher than his total HP could actually be. I think he's dead.
Oh, so, wait. So, 43?
43 damage.
Oh.
Almost.
Because that's slightly less than I was expecting.
He was 5 points higher.
Well, your blades are going to kill him in his next move anyway.
Yep.
Yeah, the other one's going to stay put. The ogres, the one's going to get away from the fireball, and the other two are going to be like, fireball, we can't move.
They just stare at it.
It's like they let us into a choke point!
Wait a minute, I think that one guy may have been bait.
Menendez! Wait, Menendez already took his turn.
Yeah, I held, so that moves me back down. Or that moves me down to after the first giant's move.
Yeah, so that gives you initiative of 4.
Oh my god.
That's so Stanton.
Well, there's only one within my channel range, so it's not really worth it.
Call it mean names.
What are some like racial slurs that you would yell at us?
Ooh, Theodore knows this! Theodore studied all of those curse words.
She did.
So she tells you a whole bunch of giant curses.
Pebble jockey.
Yeah. You've got pebbles for balls.
Stone sucker.
The cleric is insulting our junk. Show him! It's too dark in here. Oh, never mind.
Now they've got that giant fireball there.
I want their dicks to take burn damage.
So now you all got ogre and giant.
Well, that depends. If their dicks have reach, then they'd hit the fireball.
Are you saying that they get sexually aroused?
I was going to say, it's important. Are they erect or flaccid?
I have no vids. I have clustered shots. Can I aim for their genitals?
Can I roll to seduce them?
Pull up the book of erotic fantasy. Read it now.
No!
I want to see that beautiful dildo picture.
They just whip them out. Like, take this, cleric of Avanar!
They whip them out fast enough that it whips up into the fire.
Yeah! There we go.
Stanton, what are you doing?
That's what he does.
I'm watching giants flick their dicks into fire.
Stanton, you realize that all the way back at Sandpoint, Esther is just going... Something horrible just happened. My brother is the cause of it.
I feel 5 souls crying out.
Happy! Are you still holding it?
Shit. I guess.
Kurt!
I can do it.
Are you shooting at the one?
Yes.
Yeah.
He's going to die.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm gonna try something. Well, actually, no, because he's about dead anyways, isn't he?
No, yeah. Just shoot him once. Just finish him.
I can shoot him, like, a million times.
Finish.
Well, you can shoot one and then aim for the other one.
Yep.
Yeah, you can use your other two attacks on other targets.
I'll shoot that one there.
Okay, so roll. Roll!
Oh, boy. One. No. Hold on. Oh, it's a 24.
24 will hit.
Wait. Hold on. Yes. Yeah.
Did you study him?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
No.
Do your homework?
Wait. How far away am I?
Did you do your taxes?
Too far to study.
Am I...
Or that first one you'd be able to. After him, you wouldn't be able to.
Yeah, it was. I just had to make sure, because my bonuses change based on how far I am, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a 24.
Alright, so roll damage. You just need 5 points.
We can do it.
Dun, 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 dun.
Yay! Yay!
So he's...
I did...
Well, how dead do you make
it? I did 6 plus, whatever it is. Plus 2, so 8.
Oh, okay, he's incapacitated, then he's not actually dead.
Yeah.
Well, and the lady said don't kill any stone giants, so you just leave them.
So we were lucky that you didn't just straight up, like, crit him.
That stone giant is now down and effectively bleeding out. So every round, he's going to lose a hit point until he hits his...
It's stabilized.
Until it's stabilized or it hits its negative con bonus.
I'm assuming it has a large con bonus, because it's a big rock man.
19.
Yeah, I know what you're trying to say. Yeah.
Lucy!
I'm going to whack my stick in its face.
Lucy,
make it all
Theo.
Lucy rolls the ball up to the top one.
Alright.
I'm gonna make a character that just acts that way, Will.
Just like,
Alright, it's gonna make a reflex.
You just have really low intelligence, you can't speak.
It doesn't make it.
It'd be great if he had like an intelligence of like 28, but he had like a charisma of 3.
7?
Yeah.
Okay.
Social anxiety!
He can't express himself.
Theodora yells giant curses.
They get more pissed off.
Ogre and stone giant curses.
Speak giant. So
okay.
What happens when their rage meter fills up all the way?
Since Theodora has fly, would she be able to avoid your
fire
blade wreath or whatever?
Technically.
I imagine the blades are flying.
So you could stand adjacent to him, right, and not get hurt. Just for when the next one comes up.
She could be next to him.
Okay, yeah. Because
it's tall enough for giants, so even 5 feet above, she would be out of range. So she would be at head level.
Nice. Alright, so that one's...
That's where you want to be anyway. Yeah. Go for the eyes, right?
Oh, so that stone giant's going to be there.
Go for the eyes,
he's
bro.
Going
go
to
for the eyes.
Pull a rock from the wall, and he's going to throw it at Menendez.
Oh.
He is rock throwing.
Uh-oh.
What kind of action would it be to take a rock from
I was going to say, how long do you think that took?
Yeah, that's like...
Yeah.
That has to be a move action.
That's just quick standard, draw. Come on.
Their rock throwing allows them to just grab rocks and throw it.
Yeah, grab a rock that's available, not just grab
walls
and throw them.
I was flavoring
it. That takes some excavation tools.
What, they just, like, carry fucking boulders on their back? Well, I might have to throw this
someday. Creature is an accomplished rock thrower, has a +1 racial bonus on attack rolls with thrown rocks, can hurl rocks up to 2 categories smaller than its size.
That's it?
A large hill giant can hurl small rocks. A rock is any large, bulky, relatively regular-shaped object made of a material with a hardness of at least 5, can hurl the rock up to 5 range increments. Size of the range increments vary within the creature. Damage of the thrown rock is generally twice the creature's base slam plus 1.5 times its strength.
But it doesn't say anything about where he gets the rocks from. You can't just tear them out of fucking walls. Like, that takes a strength check to break the fucking rock with your hands.
Fine, he grabs one laying on the ground.
So there you go.
There! We solved the problem.
Trying to add flavor to the attack guide.
Wait, this was a problem? You made it a problem.
Does 29 hit Menendez?
It does not.
Okay.
But if I was successful in my arguments, then...
We would have not got hit by rocks?
Yes! This is why you hire lawyers!
Is Stan also a lawyer?
God of law.
God of law.
Oh my god.
Technically.
Abadar's the god of law.
Technically, he is an actual rules lawyer.
Literally. Yeah.
The giant tries to rip a stone out and he walks up. Hold on now! Buddy!
That's going to take at least a standard action to do that.
I better see a strength check.
Abadar's god of law.
What's the durability of the wall?
Right.
Dude. Is this wall now up to code?
How many of my strength is? 25! Not good enough!
We're gonna have to check this with the courthouse.
Mandanez, you're up.
Fourth wall.
Finkles are bankers.
How far away is that?
Mendez.
I think he's also the god of bankers or something like that.
Yes. All you just have money.
25.
Huh? Is going to...
That would make sense. Move up.
I was going to say...
Abadar. I am a deity who is based on the laws made of mortal creatures. Nice. Yes. Wrap your head around that, folks.
That means that Abadar...
Mendez is going to move up to him.
You move right in front of him, down there on the bottom of this one. I can move up to the top and not get hit by swords.
He gets an attack of opportunity.
Okay. So he gets to do a snap.
I bet it doesn't hit.
No, it doesn't.
What a surprise!
Hey, look.
What if I hate that spot?
Woohoo!
Uh-oh.
Confirm it. What'd
you get, a 36 or something?
You confirmed it.
Oh my god.
Woo!
Now let's see if you can do over 100 damage.
No.
Okay.
So that's...
One. I don't know. He's having internet problems. What?
I saw that.
I'm not sure what that was about.
That's what I like.
That was the stone giants.
Dick going up?
Yeah.
Why?
He's thinking of his wife back at home.
Oh no. Thinking of his wife?
She just gave birth to twins.
Oh, stop throwing out those death flags.
That poor guy.
Because he saw Mendez coming out like...
He might want that sword in his gut right now.
Because he's dying, he's like,
because he just had twins. I feel his pain.
Yeah.
Time to slow down for him.
Yeah.
My wife just had twins. She's the most beautiful stone giant in our tribe.
Thank you.
Alright, what did we get? Oh, just 27? Okay.
Well, there was no magic involved, so.
Okay.
So he's not a puddle.
No.
Mendez is having to limit himself to save resources. Okay, this one is going to try to get out of the scary fire.
Get out of town.
Would that cause a... Because he moved through it again, didn't he?
No, it wouldn't count.
Okay. Okay.
I think the router died, Will.
The other two ogres are going to stay put because they don't want to mess with the bad burning fire. But the ogre who moved is going to take a swing at Mendez. For...
He's going to tear a rock out of
29, so no. Stanton.
Alright. Stanton. Perfect. Channel negative energy.
Oh my god, I knew it.
So,
like you didn't see it coming.
Three targets.
You didn't see it coming.
You would also be hitting the one who's unconscious on the ground.
I can exclude him. I got that power.
Okay then. Just very wanted to make
good.
Sure.
Name it.
Let's see, Will's what? 5 and...
Where are you?
7. Alright, so, let's see. The stone giant in front of Mendez got a 27 on his Will save.
Jesus. Fuck it.
The... Oh, got 18.
Nope.
The other one got 21.
Nope.
Alright, so just the main stone giant.
Let's see that. Da-da-da-da. I'm dropping my shit
all over the place.
You don't need all that garbage anyway.
It's just a character sheet.
Ugh. I'm okay.
29.
Dang.
Ignore any noises.
So, 14 for one what? Saved.
I was ignoring them until you brought attention to them.
I wasn't talking to you.
Well, now you are.
Okay, goodbye.
Alright. Effie.
Oh yeah, don't forget, everyone was getting plus one on these rolls,
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that.
What?
I will remember.
Because he blessed us.
Yeah.
We all get the plus ones for attack. And damage.
Oh.
Just attack.
Just attack.
Oh, okay.
Ah, I'm out cool. Again. I need my virtual dice because give I'm special. You might just have to give me yours.
What exactly are you rolling for?
Don't know.
Aren't you going to move up?
I mean, I'm going to roll.
Well, here, I'll get you queued up.
Alright, I'm gonna go, I think it's 25 feet to that ogre.
30,
yeah, I'm gonna move on. I'm gonna go one, wait, no shit, I can't move up. Because if I go there, I'm gonna get two attacks on me.
Well, people typically only get one attack of opportunity, so.
Yeah, like, already used his unmended.
Oh, okay, never mind, then I'm going there.
Yeah, so you're only getting an attack of opportunity from the ogre.
Yes.
Ouch.
So you're right here.
Tell me, does a 19 hit you?
Huh, no.
Well, then you saved yourself from being crit, so he only got a regular attack on you.
Oh my god.
So,
2d8.
Oh, so you got 25 damage done to you. And make your attack roll on whoever.
Give me.
Are you hitting the ogre or the stone giant?
I'm gonna hit the giant.
Alright.
How much have we done today?
Not a lot.
Not a lot? Yeah, I'm gonna attack him then.
The giant?
Yeah.
Alright.
Alright.
Roll for it!
This is just a normal attack, so. I'm gonna do power attack.
Alright. Minus 3, plus 9.
Yeah. Shit. Okay, that's a 9 plus 17.
9 plus 7. That would hit.
Yeah. And then we're gonna do... Give me 2d6. 2d6 plus 19. Oh my god, wow. I think I just...
12 plus 19.
Fucked him up.
What is that, 31?
Yeah. Got him pretty hard, but he's still standing. Kirk!
I shoot gun.
Wait. I do job.
Which one are you hitting, the ogre or the giant?
Just whatever.
Which one has a low raise?
Actually, what's my range right now?
You
should be able to check it. Not on... 35 and 40. I'm gonna use a move action then to, I'll move up behind Stanton, just to get a little closer before I attack. Yeah.
Friend!
And then, so after a move action...
You only get the one attack.
I just get the one, okay. So my full round is when I get the three, if I do a four round attack.
How much HP did that guy do to me? 25?
And yeah. I'm gonna shoot the giant again.
Alright.
Is a 30 hit?
Yes.
Cool.
That's a very hit. Did you get a crit?
No.
What's your bonus on that first one? 18.
Slayers have a full base attack bonus. So.
I was gonna say you didn't hit a crit. You got 30.
Well, yeah, because I get that big plus 18 bonus.
Okay.
Oh, great! I did a whopping 1 damage. No, wait, three. I'm sorry.
Three damage.
I mean, good job. You're hitting the giant, too.
Lucy and Theo.
Lucy moves the ball of fire into one of the other giants. Yeah.
You know.
Oh, oh my god! Oh, I'm on fire! Oh, Jesus! Oh. 17?
Nope. 5.
The druid doesn't talk much, but she certainly hits.
And then Theodora flies up between them.
Did she do that?
As in, right here?
No, back there. Okay. Yeah. And bites. Where's my D4?
Oh, no! Interference!
Which one is she attacking?
They're gonna be jamming us if they don't know where.
Break off the attack.
5 plus 12? Why?
5 plus 12? No.
No? Okay.
Raspberry.
Never mind.
He was making a sword.
Oh, okay. She tries and it doesn't work.
Stone giants. Raspberry. The snozzberries taste like snozzberries.
Before he does anything else.
Okay.
He needs to make a reflex save. Needs a 19.
No.
Take 17 damage.
Not really.
I think he's done.
What?
Yeah, the blades.
What is that? A 5d6?
Yep.
Yeah, that's pretty big.
Alright, so the stone giant is going to try to... He's going to do his two slam attacks on Metal.
The cool thing about it is you can also enchant the blades. And so, like, if I have, say, +1 flaming mithril daggers on the, on the start of their turn, it does, it would do 5d6, +1, +1d6 fire damage.
can you, like, command them to go fly at people?
No, they just stay around me.
Cool. You know, like, if you ever watch those, like, robot fighting shows where it just has, like, the spinning blades on it, you just have to get it close.
Yeah, that's basically it.
He's going to end his turn by taking a 5-foot step, and you're up.
Where's he going? BattleBots back.
5-foot step back.
That's not how he, like, ran away in the episode.
Oh, you don't have to step
up. I do, actually.
Yeah, I was going to say, you don't have
So, going to just follow him.
Alright.
And actually, I do get an attack of opportunity with that.
Really?
I think.
Do you have the whole tree with the following step stuff?
I think following step.
If you 5-foot step up here, wouldn't you be able to hit both with your spinning blade thingamajigs?
He couldn't. Oh, yes, he could.
But then he'd hit me. Effie.
Yeah.
True.
And then I cry because I'm getting stabbed by knives.
You know, these are the sacrifices we have to make.
You're the fire!
You're the fighter.
Get over it!
Just take the knife.
No, I can't.
You'll get healed and it'll all be okay.
Okay, but they hurt. It's still your turn anyway.
Okay.
The cleric will just stick his wand in.
What? That's how it works? Last time he did that, he gave me a disease.
In that case...
And now Leary goes, something awful just happened.
Full rounds.
Uh-oh. I think my boyfriend is cheating on me.
No, he has, like, an actual, like, wand of cure light wounds, and he sticks it in
we know what you're talking about.
Yeah, we know what you're talking about.
Alright.
Okay.
Alright, I just want to be clear.
Hey, look!
Net 20!
Oh, this guy's gonna be
re-roll.
Just
23 confirmed?
Yes, by 1 point.
Okay. So, first attack does...
1 point? Off by 1 point, the 1 point given by Bless.
Ooh. But seriously, this giant's dead.
He did 23 damage?
No, that was to confirm.
Oh, okay.
So it's... 2 6 plus...
Hi-yo!
So, 28 damage.
Alright, that is going to make him drop down to -18.
Yeah, so he's a little dead.
He's almost dead!
Okay, Menendez is then going to 5-foot step up and attack the ogre.
Wait, couldn't you step to the upper right of that giant so you don't attack me?
Yeah. Right there.
Yeah, that.
So that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 6. 15 damage.
Almost.
Wait.
What is the ogre bit for? Yes.
That would be
damage.
My mom's like third strong.
She's like a strength of
4 more damage than that.
Maybe less.
So you got one who's about to drop dead and the other one who's still slowly bleeding out. Ogres
are like onions.
Yeah.
So oh, you leave them out in the sun too long, they grow those little white hairs.
That one's going to get away from that. That one is within 10-foot range, so he's going to strike at Menendez.
Boo.
For a 29.
Nope.
So no. Yeah.
That's your third 29 on him.
I know.
He's trying his hardest. The worst thing is, those are like good attack rolls.
Yeah.
Yeah, they are. It's
a
just...
A party throw 21.
He has such high fucking AC. The other ogre is going to attack Ethel.
Oh my god, finally, someone's paying attention to me.
With a 19!
And he completely misses.
Notice me.
I'm being noticed.
Notice me!
Notice me, simple.
The other one can't do anything because he still has his hook drawn. So
he actually started his turn in range of the
Reef
of Blades.
He's gonna eat shit.
He needs the reflex save. It was 19.
He got a 19.
Okay, so he takes 11 points of damage.
He drops.
Wait, really?
Yeah.
What
he's
hit him?
Down to -5
the
now.
Reef of Blades.
No, I mean, what hit him before? Where did all that HP go?
I think I hit him a few times. Is that
yeah,
the
few times he hit him, the I think you hit
no,
him.
No, I haven't hit him once.
Well, then he hit him a bunch
of times. Yeah, I hit him once.
Oh, and the channel.
And the channel.
Did that do that much?
Channeling's pretty good.
Yeah.
All right.
The only problem is, like, the reason I don't want to stick with Stanton for too much longer is because he's, like, kind of hit, like, the end of his growth potential. From this point on, all he can really do is get, like, little fun off-to-the-side feats, and that's... He's not going to be able to keep up with everyone else.
So if we keep him along for too much longer, he'll hit his, like, midlife crisis pretty much.
Right. Yeah.
And we that'll make for some fun role-playing. We're going to, like, get you through it. You, like, want to buy, like, a fancy sword or something. Like, no, Stan.
You're a cleric.
You're a cleric. The time in your life to role fighter is past.
Multi-class to, like, necromancer. He's going through a tough time.
Multi-class in the barbarian for a little bit.
I mean, clerics can actually make really solid necromancers in Pathfinder.
I played a 3.5 D&D where somebody built a necromancer cleric. It was not fun on my end because he was like, I get to summon these giant-sized skeletons that can fight for me. So, yeah, there we go. I got giant skeletons. And he had this one fucking skeleton that would never, ever die because all the bonuses he granted to it made it a Menendez. It had such high AC and HP.
And he's hard to hit because if you, like, try to shoot him, it just goes through his bones.
Yeah.
It became a running joke for that skeleton to be the savior of the day because it was the tank of the party. We all eventually was just like, yeah, go Skelly!
You should have made it, like, upset that it was being used in this way and made it turn on the party.
Your real
thing. Stan, what are you going to do?
You've abused this poor skeleton too much.
Let's see.
You
know what maybe, you need to do. Did you stabilize that giant that's dying? I mean, it doesn't really matter.
The one's only at -5, and yeah. He loses a point per round, but the other one's at -18, so he's going to drop dead.
Does the lady care about ogres?
No.
She said stone giants. Don't kill the stone giants.
Yeah, so I'm going to chop this ogre's fucking tail.
I can murder as many ogres as I want.
Yeah.
No stone giants.
Yes.
Because that makes my job a lot easier. Because I can only exclude 7 people from my channel.
Only 7. Oh, wow, so, yeah.
1, 2...
So are those ogres or stone giants?
The big ones that with the clubs are ogres and stone giants are done. They're gone.
Yeah.
Okay.
The stone giants are the ones that don't have the white background.
Okay, so, are any of them... You said one was at -18.
The one that Menides is standing on is going to drop dead if
he doesn't heal
it reaches
him.
Their turn and
or you okay. Heal him because you're gonna go before he does.
Can you not exclude one person?
I was just going to not exclude this guy because
yeah, fuck him. He's
yeah.
Who gives a shit?
But like
filthy ogre.
Like if anyone else joined the fight right now, I could not exclude them.
What about the flame spear? Will you hit that?
I mean,
shut up.
It doesn't really.
Alright, so the two ogres you're able to hit. One rolled a 19, the other one rolled a 12. Nope. Okay.
They're dead.
23. Oh my god. Crikey.
So, they're both still standing, but they're getting low. Effie!
They're getting low?
Yeah.
Just like that song?
Yeah.
Hey, little John?
No? Yeah.
You mean, like, the Robin Hood hero?
No. The rapper.
Oh.
From the Dirty South.
Effie, you're up.
Alright, I am going to run on through Menides. Let's see. Because if I stand there...
Leroy!
Can he stand, right on that one? That one? Can he stand there, Menides? Or anyone, I guess,
stand
on the
where?
Edge there?
In that
where
corner?
He's got it, yeah, that one. Can you stand there? Okay.
Alright.
Yeah.
I'm gonna move up in front, above the ogre. Not there. Up.
Not there.
Up, yeah, there.
There.
Now you'll get 2 attacks of opportunity if you do that.
No, just one.
No, they have 2. They have 10
because they haven't used it.
Well, if,
but if you there's also a giant
it's
only
there. One because he's stepping into the range
of the first one.
Oh,
not
yeah.
So one rolls a 25.
Yeah, that'll do it.
Okay.
You'll probably make it.
Probably.
Say you'll tank through the test.
You took 18 damage.
Yeah, no, like, let me do math.
Make your single attack roll.
Who, me?
Yeah. You still get to attack, you moved.
What if I just wanted to move?
Well, you're an idiot.
Take clubs to my face, that's my favorite thing. Okay. Thanks for doing math. Give me the dice. I'm gonna do a power attack as well. So we got...
Human woman at good height.
What does that mean?
They still have their dick slipped out.
Oh, that's a power attacking.
Alright, well, fucking this guy, since I got a +1 from Bless, I am critting him.
No, that's your natural role.
Yeah, you have to actually roll that.
Yeah, your bonus is
fine. I was 1-off.
You're 1-off. You could have lobbed his member off.
Alright, so what'd you get?
I got a 16 plus a 17, so yeah. It definitely hits him.
Yeah, roll damage.
Give me...
2d6.
Well, thanks for letting us use your dice.
Yeah.
Even though we both have dice now, we just forget them.
Okay.
We're just
you don't mind if there's just, like, semen all over my hand, do you?
Actually, I would prefer it.
Alright! This works for the both of us.
Jesus.
Aw, man.
Snake eyes.
But I got... Okay, so I got 2 plus 19.
Woohoo! 21! You knocked him down to 10 hit points.
Damn you. I wanted that crit.
Curl.
Oh, wait, no. I got 2 plus 20 because of Bless. So I did 22.
It doesn't
Bless only counts
towards attack. What the hell does it do?
It just boosts your attack.
Okay, so I have to... Oh, never mind. I was confused.
It's a level 1 spell.
I understand.
You can't expect... Which giant is the one that's going next?
The one that Minutes is standing on top of.
So at his turn, will he die?
No.
Yeah.
So...
Lucy will stabilize, I'm pretty sure.
Lucy has to be able to get up to him. Yeah. Yeah, she's so far away.
All right. I would have to run, and I think...
What do you need to roll to stabilize and heal?
No, how about this?
The heal skill.
You, I have heal skill. How about instead, you run up to him and feed him some potions?
If you run up and you pull the wand out of my butt, and you touch it to the guy, you can heal.
Or we can do that.
Okay.
Is trading a swift action?
Yeah, what is that, a standard action to... I have quick draw. Can I quick draw it from him?
Yeah. You know what, let's just rule it.
You can do whatever you want. If it was me, I would say something like, make a sleight of hand check or something to pull it out of his bag.
Well, like, it's probably not like he's stealing
he's
it from
slayer,
me.
He's a slayer, though.
It's not like he's stealing it from me. I'm like,
he
hey,
fails his sleight of hand check and grabs Stan's dick.
It works for everyone!
Except the guy who's dying.
I roll a nat 1 on my sleight of hand check and I pull it off.
After that, we would both have to roll.
After that, we would both have to roll sense motive.
You okay? Okay.
Are you sure?
After giving Stan the quick hand job.
For sake,
you get that if he gets a 20.
You need a high marker.
I'm good.
Okay.
I think for
so
sake,
I had just taken a big gulp right when he said that.
Oh, shit.
I was gonna say, I hope I'm not responsible for killing Joe.
Okay.
Derek gets a hero point for almost killing
him. I can breathe again.
Okay, so for
do
the sake...
Do I get
sake-
more if I actually kill him?
No. For the sake of time, and that we almost killed somebody, you know, you run up between them and you're like, give me one! Wait, go.
That's not my wand!
just take the wand out of my pocket.
Why is it in between your butt cheeks?
Hey, this isn't about me.
This stone giant owes me.
Will, what kind of cure wand was it? Light or moderate?
Cure light wounds.
So 1d8. Woohoo! Now, when you're... Remind me again, when you're healing... What?
He's stable now.
Okay. So he's stable at 0 hit points. So he's still unconscious, but he's no. But
no,
he is
he's at 0 hit points. He's conscious again. He's just prone and staggered.
Yeah.
Somebody kick him a little bit.
So he wakes up. He's like, oh no, I'm surrounded by humans. This is not a good day for me, Lucy.
Minutus is like on top of him.
There's a human standing on me!
Yes.
You're just, you just click and crouch repeatedly.
What is he doing?!
Where did this shotgun come from?
Lucy moves the ball down. Onto him.
Reflex!
Lucy, you dropped the ball. Get it, because
wow.
The ball...
Does 22 help him?
I take 20 points of damage, Will.
Get on the ball. Remember that OxyClean, like, stain fighting ball?
Yes!
Alright, so he takes half the damage.
How much is that?
I mean, probably a lot, because
Eight.
The
minibase
is dead, and they don't sell.
They sell OxyClean.
So he's just like, no! Fireman!
Yeah. And then Theo flies up to the bottom one. Yeah.
Here. Yes.
And does it bite?
What?
You need to get Vince with slack.
Excuse me. 16 plus 12?
Yeah, that'll hit.
Watch this. You're gonna love that.
The prostitute.
Maybe she liked him too much and he had to, like, physically
beat her off. What?
You know the guy that sold the slap chop?
No.
Oh, well, he was the, like, everyone's like, he's the next Billy Mays, and then he, like, beat a prostitute and went to jail, so it's
in the early last one. When he was doing the slap chop commercial, there was a line where he goes, you're gonna love my nuts, watch.
Yeah, he's like, watch this,
and he's cutting up nuts with the slap chop. So the joke is, she didn't love his nuts.
This is a relic from times past.
Gotcha.
Okay, so they're still fine.
It's been a minute. It's been a hot minute.
What's the slap chop?
One's at 2 hit points, the other's at 19. So pick one and kill it.
He's gonna say, I don't know, move up.
Menadez is going to saunter to here.
Saunter?
Is that a move action? A saunter?
Is that like a teleport jaunt or something?
Well, the one who hasn't done an attack of opportunity yet is going to make one. No.
He just like shimmies between them.
Scoozy. Scoozy.
He ducks under his legs.
He just walks.
Yeah. Can you touch
me? True.
Can Manus teleport at all?
Yeah. But only like spell.
Which one do you want to kill?
Let's see.
All of them. Stick out your sword and start spinning.
One to the. Which one looks worse?
The one to your right. He's at 2 hit points.
Okay, then I'm gonna attack the one up top.
Okay, he's at 19 hit points.
Okay.
You think you'd probably kill that one with 2?
I mean, they're...
You have the potential to kill both of them, what I
their
mean.
Their turn starts after his...
Does a 25 hit?
Start yes.
Well, then it's a crit.
Well, shit,
okay,
maybe you shouldn't have done
he's
that.
Dead.
Oh, wait, never mind. These are not giants. Okay, have fun.
That's a dead
28 over. Damage.
Yeah, he's dead.
The one to the north?
Yeah.
He had 2
like I said, he had 19 hit points left.
Oh, he's down, but he's not dead.
Yeah, he's at 8 or 9, but either way.
I mean, we really don't care about those guys.
No.
Unless they have the symbol.
Effie, Theodora, and Menendez, you three get attacks opportunities, because the one is seeing all of his friends down, and you all surround him, he's like... You know what? Fuck this place. And he wants to try to make a run for it. For this tunnel.
For this way?
Yeah, the tunnel that leads him towards the... Lamaz, Lamia, however you pronounce it.
Lamia.
Lamia's.
Now, what is an attack of opportunity? What do you roll? Is that just 20?
Just your highest attack.
Nat 20, plus 12.
Oh.
Alright,
hold on,
let
me see what
confirm.
Mine
does. A 23 hit.
23 will hit.
He takes 14 damage from Menendez.
Alright, so...
11 plus 12?
Yeah, so Theodora crits too.
He's dead.
He turns into a fine red mist.
So it would be 13 plus 20? I'm confused.
Yeah.
3 plus 5 times 2.
Pretty much.
Your base attack bonus would be, what, 11 now? So
yay.
11 plus whatever you rolled.
It's 11 because of my trait or whatever. I have fencer. Yeah, I got it.
11 plus your strength.
Yeah,
plus
it's plus 10 damage.
And you're flanking him, so
he's dead anyway.
He's like he's
super
dead.
This is all
so you're using the greatsword plus 2. So your initial roll is a d20 plus 20.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you did
plus strength plus
you
11.
Hit.
Plus
yeah.
Blanking.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Plus like, one for bless.
50 so, yeah. damage.
So, yeah, Menendez stabs him. Theodora, with her critical hit, bites out his jugular.
Oh!
And Effie slices him in half.
Oh my god.
That is why you don't run.
Fuck this, I'm out.
Just all bloody now, like after a fight in Dragon Age.
Yeah.
And then you're gonna go talk to royalty who doesn't care.
Yeah.
And you hear the dwarves going, hey! What's going on out there?
We ignore
the
them.
Dragon!
We ignore them!
Do we keep fighting this flame?
Yes!
Free the dragon!
Oh!
shit! It stinks!
Oh my god. Yeah, so just leave it. It's not even worth whatever's in the armory.
It's cool, but it has nose plugs. He takes off the nose plugs and puts them in. Now he doesn't smell it.
Just gonna leave us here?
Oh, now you have to breathe through your mouth, though.
No, those were all jokes.
He does actually have nose plugs.
Nice!
Why did you buy nose plugs for him? What did you foresee?
You never know when you're gonna run into a dwarf that just shat himself.
I guess we should go free the dwarf.
He also has earplugs.
Those are very,
like,
very
that makes sense, but, like, nose plugs?
Hey!
And they, like, don't weigh anything, so you might as well.
So, do you all free the dwarves?
Yes.
We all free the dwarves. They look weird.
They grab whatever weapons they can off the wall, and they're like, is there a clear way out of here?
Free the dragons! Yep.
We point him to the cave.
Well...
To the cave!
Wait!
They all
hope they can fly!
They can climb down and swim.
You think they can climb down?
So, they all just take off running.
Maybe we should have, like...
It's like...
The one stops and he's like, you! I heard tales of you! Uh-huh. Maybe, I'm not sure. Are you related to any other dwarves?
To Menides?
Yeah.
He's not related to dwarves, no.
Were you raised by dwarves, dammit?
Yes.
What were their names?
The Feely, Keely,
I've got it written down.
Feely...
Like the comic character?
ZZ Top.
Comet.
Dwarves.
Comet Dwarves? I do business with them! At least I used to! So I'll tell them that we saw you! Bye!
Well, that was strange.
Yep, Nate, I'll take off running.
You gain +1 to your confidence.
Can we look around the armory and see if there's some cool stuff for us to have?
Not really.
I loot it!
It's all broken, bent-up swords and whatnot. And they're all sized for giants, so none of you can really use them.
I can use them.
Except for the barbarian, who's no longer here.
Right.
I can use them. I got a...
Lucy maybe takes one and...
Takes a present back to Carmen.
Yeah. Wraps it in a bow.
Jesus, are you going to carry that?
you get the giant knife.
Yeah.
It breaks after one use.
He'll see it and he's like,
no, it's
you
like
brought me a giant butter knife.
No, it's not.
Oh, I love it!
Yes, like, you know, like, 5 hits, the thing is fucking...
So like, he would say it, he'd see the look on his face and be like,
I
love it!
I'm thinking of the razor sword.
Yeah, I'm thinking of the razor sword.
Alright, so,
Yeah, the giant's knife just breaks the second you pull it out.
Alright, so, before we call it here, let me ask the ultimate question. Are you all going to pretty much head straight to the library from here?
Dragons!
Or are you going to try for the two snake ladies and the dragons?
We're getting the fuck out of here.
Dragons!
Wait, I mean...
It depends on how much experience we gain, because if we could fight the little snakes, then maybe we could... No, we probably could level up, could we?
No, we're not going to get...
Well, but if we could kill the snakes without
actually,
even encountering the dragon.
That's true.
Yeah.
We might. We probably have to take the dragons on as well.
Cool. Would you? Zoom out on your map. I want to see...
I don't know if Theodora would help us.
If they started trying to eat her, she might.
That's true. Maybe they would start trying to eat her.
Oh my god, you zoomed a good bit.
Here be
but there's
dragons.
A choke point. They wouldn't be able to fit through the choke point.
They could squeeze.
Yeah, any creature can squeeze through a 5-foot square. They would just have
holy
penalties
shit.
For being in the 5-foot square.
Yeah.
I mean, it would basically slow them down long enough for us to get away, but it wouldn't stop them.
We couldn't use Fire Snake on
them. But like the Stone Giant said, they are chained, so they're trapped in that room.
I'm assuming they can also just breathe fire, still.
Yeah.
But those...
So can Menides.
Yeah.
You're gonna bring
you
fire back
like
in the Red Dragon?
I thought you were talking like...
Sure, and I'll turn it into ice.
Oh, that was...
Yeah.
Bring it on, bitches.
So, you got two clerics of Lamatsu, two Red Dragons, or you can all just say you take a straight shot to the library.
I mean, those dragons might be grateful if we...
This is pretty much me asking, where are we picking up next week? Going after them, or going to the next map?
Lamias!
I want to kill some Lamias.
Lamias.
I'm pretty sure that's what
I don't
want to
fight, right?
Never heard it pronounced.
Yeah, Mina desperately likes Theodora, and so he votes with her.
Shit. I didn't know they were friends.
Well, let's do this.
I'm not going to get rid of Stan anyway.
Really? Oh, no!
Ever since the fort, when she said, hey, let's burn this, and Mina Des went, okay, and shot a fireball at it.
They bonded.
They
understand me. Did those ogres and giants have anything on them at all? Like,
Not really anything of importance or value.
And they smell really bad. You do not want to say so.
This one had a stick up its ass. Gross.
Joe, if I might ask, is there any spell or whatnot that would come to your mind that would give the benefits of a full rest?
Not that we'd have access to.
You know how in Morrowind you can just sleep in a dungeon and no one gives a crap?
Wait for 7 hours?
Yeah.
Well, are you trying to restock, like, spells and stuff?
Yeah.
Well,
I could choose, like, blizzard spells and stuff.
I, as a GM, and not really wanting to kill players, just want to remind you all that your characters are on limited resources, and this wouldn't be the best place to take an 8-hour rest to refuel yourself.
I mean, we would need to be careful.
We could sleep in the spider caves. No, because then we'd have to go through.
But
the
they all know we're here.
I mean, isn't this place? Yeah. Isn't this design so no one could rest really?
Yes.
Yeah.
So then it probably won't be a problem.
Reading through this section, this is an endurance run.
Yeah, I imagine that's what it was meant to be.
So how about we not waste time trying to fight dragons and
yeah, because we don't have we don't like have our spells. You guys don't. I don't have any spells because I don't have spells.
Why couldn't you just pick characters that just hit things with a stick?
Minidez is in pretty good shape.
Because then I could deal 22 damage to every single monster on the field.
That's true.
Well, when I get my teleport feed, I'll be able to do that too.
So let's do this democratically.
It's like an anime.
Let's do this democratically. The players who want to stay on this map and go after the clerics and dragons, raise your hand.
I'm going to be the deciding one because I know both of you.
So that's two. Who are the players that want to sort next week, moving immediately to the next map?
Oh.
Yeah. You are the deciding vote.
So, like, fighting things is fun and stuff?
Wait, remember. I drove us here.
What are you implying?
I'm just stating
stating facts.
It's like the banker who says, hey, remember, I gave you all that money.
So...
Blackmail! Blackmail!
You know, if we really wanted to, after we beat our friend hiding in the library, we could come back here, and I don't know if...
Yeah, because after all,
things would
leaves,
be nice.
We could just take a little nap
the stone giants will definitely leave once Mugmorin is dealt with.
You think the Lamias will, too? Though?
They would probably take their pet dragons with them. Because at this point, that's what they are.
I can only tell you what Kana has told you. And she gave you her word that she would gather up the Stone Giant tribes and leave the Jorgenfist area.
And didn't she say that the dragons were chained anyways?
Yeah.
So, I mean, couldn't we just go kill the Lamias?
Yeah, but
and
they
then...
can breathe fire still.
They're in a like little alcove. Even if they breathe fire, they're not going to touch us.
Yeah, so we could just kill the Lamias so they can't take the pets back with them, and then we could go fight Melkor.
And also
Melkor.
And also remember that she said that the dragons were charmed by them.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
And you have somebody with arcane mastery here in the party who could tell you that when someone who casts a charm spell dies, said charm spell wears off.
Yeah. Well, I mean, really, it just comes down to, do you want to spend more time and possibly spells fighting two more things?
I mean, it's just two.
Yeah. They're
probably big, strong snakes.
Do you... Is Wreath of Blades a spell?
Yes.
Okay.
I mean, if... That's running for another 10 minutes, so...
If you guys don't
walk
mind...
in there with that on, then...
If you guys don't mind, like... If you guys think you have enough spells to do it, then I wouldn't mind helping you fight the Lamias. But if we have to try to fight dragons too, then we'll, I don't know. Like, we could die.
I don't think we're going to be fighting dragons.
Yeah, so, I
still have Speak with Animal and Charm Animal.
And you have Theodora too.
And Theodora, yeah.
Well,
who
then
is a dragon.
I'll change my vote to you guys if we can.
Yeah,
there's a good chance that we will.
He's still got a bunch of offensive... Touch attacks that he can throw out.
Yeah.
Touch spells that he can deliver and do all kinds of things.
Alright.
Sorry, Will. It looks like we're going the way you don't want to go.
Alright, so next week we're taking out the Lamias before moving into the final map of the chapter.
Maybe Stanton should turn evil and try and kill us because we're retarded.
So, on that note, we'll close
shop.
He
is neutral.
Oh, shit.
On that note, we'll close shop and I'll start handing out experience points. So, good night, everybody.
Night.
He's just going to start channeling negative energy and, like, not excluding us.
Just, like, all of us.
Not telling anyone about it. Just start
like,
doing
oh,
it.
Oh, it hurts.
My heart.
What's going on?
Good night.